Hello, welcome to Outward. So today I'll just visit a high event. Well, maybe we'll give them some presents. Some cold axes or swords or something like that. Anyway, this is the World Hive. Colossal Hive, actually. This is also the Colossal Hive. But as you can see, the Vigil Pylon is over there. So it's just south of the Vigil Pylon, if you're wondering how to get here. And you can see it from there. But before we go in, let's have a little chat with the inhabitants. I think he noticed me. Hey, I'm not ready. Why do these monsters always attack me when I'm not ready? I will give you my word. I'll let you know when I'm ready. Oh, you're fast. Let's use one of those. Warrior Elixir is always nice. Such a beast. And this is the Hive Lord. The Hive Lord. He doesn't have that good loot, but hey, the occult remains are pretty nice to sell. Okay, let's forget all of this. I wasn't even ready. They are so mean to me sometimes. Now let's see. Bread of the Wild is a nice one. Also Marshmallow Jelly. Full stamina regen. Well, I have my water. Maybe the Assassin's Elixir. Ah, whatever. That was not a good choice, but let's go in. Yeah. I think I'll stop wearing my armor, because most enemies are weak anyway, so I think the main armor is pretty sufficient. So here there should be an ornate chest. Again, I really hate I have to draw my sword all the time. Was another mistake. Fortunately, he's not so bad. Yeah. I think I'll stop using my pistol as well. Now let's just use a bandage and move on, because this should be a very easy dungeon for us at this point. But again, I'll just be checking some of the loot around here. Scavenger corpse and some of the artwork, because I don't want to skip a lot of things. Okay, that was very, very interesting. So let's move on. Oh, you want to fight too? Where? They attack so slow sometimes. Okay, next. Who's next in line? Exactly what I wanted. Oh, I was too far away. I don't know why people use the two-handed weapons. They feel so clunky and big. Just a little skeleton. Now let's see, this is the ornate chest right here, Thorn, Chakra, Plate, Armor, what's with this loot? Usually it's not this good. I'll just have to pick that up when I am gone, because right now I don't have the... Or do I? No, I don't, let's move on. They're always trying to distract me with their things. So okay, that was just another Hive Lord. That was the ornate chest. So not through here. From what I know, I have to go up somewhere. Uh, Okay, that's just an iron chest, but we have the ornate chest. That's plenty. No. The danger of having too much speed. You can kill yourself with this much speed, yeah. It's like I'm driving a race car. Anyway, let's go up and face the final demon. Which is just another Hive Lord, but he's called the Toxic Hive Lord. Let's just buff before we meet him. Yeah, Stealth Potion would be nice. Warrior Elixir. Stone Flesh. Could be useful. Elemental Immunity. Decent. Ice Varnish. This is like the typical MMORPG. You buff for 10 minutes. And then your buffs run out in 2 minutes, but during those 2 minutes you can kill anything. And this boss isn't supposed to be that hard. I mean, he's hard unless you... Actually, let me use all my armor, because I do more damage like this. Ah, such a peaceful location in here, isn't it? Hello? Huh, he's not home? Hello, Mr. Boss. Oh, there he is. Let's turn off our light. And let's see if we can surprise him. Let's draw our sword, because that's one of the things I hate most about the game, anyway. What? The backstab fell? Anyway, he is not so hard to kill. This is actually a Toxic Hive Lord. He's a little different. So this is the World Edge Great Axe. As you can see, all the weapons were made, I think, by the Ash Giants or their gods or something like that. Duskfather is... Okay, he's... This world is but one stop in his travel across... Okay, yeah. Whatever. So... This actually does a lot of decay damage and has a lot of speed, so that's why people are using this one. But again, this will make your game, I don't know, easier in a way, but in another way it won't be as flexible, because if you use the two-handed weapon, you'll get hit a lot. So yeah, decay, 40 decay damage and 13 physical. That's 53 damage compared to, let's say, 36. 46. This sword does actually 46 damage on the second hit. Because it has 25 increased damage and chill and pain. So, yeah, that's 36 plus 25%, which is 9. Which is 45. So, yeah, the brand does about 8 damage less than that one. To be honest, I noticed that most monsters... Yeah, are kind of weak to physical damage, depending on what they are. Besides, the impact is a little better, 48, 27, yeah. Sometimes you just have to pick and choose your battles. So it's the right weapon for the right job sometimes. Other than that, let's explore this place a bit more. There is the second ornate chest, what? Why is the game giving me so much loot? So you have two ornate chests in this location. The one is in the cave and the other one is on the outside. Well hidden in there. But not enough for me. Let's see what other things we can see in here. So there are three hives in here. So we just... What was this hive called again? I don't remember. Anyway, there should be three hives in here. The general hive, the trap hive or something like that, and the main hive. So that's the forest types. Anyway, I think it's the same thing. Maybe the wiki is wrong or something, but I usually read the wiki description and then go and do the quest. Okay, so this is not a drop down. This is simply a jump. Yeah, so I think there is only one hive. Maybe there are smaller ones in here or something like that. But this is a nice way to do a boss fight in a nice open area. Anyway, the video is mostly done. You can just press the stop button, but I want to check some other things in here. So that's everything there was to this encounter. It seems a little short, to be honest. I will go a bit south and see. Because that's the second half that you see on the map, but still, it feels a little short, I don't know. Okay, so that's another great item for my collection. I mean, soon I'll have all the unique weapons and then I can make another tutorial, another guide video to more precise on all the weapons. And by using all the named weapons, it will be a lot more fun. A little wall is my enemy. So, seems like this is all there was to this area. But since we are already here, I want to mention a few things. See this road? This road usually leads somewhere. Because these two roads lead to a location. But see this one? This is a road that has no location and it's closed down. And there have been a lot of speculation about this thing, and to be honest, I think this will be the new DLC area, because as you can see, it's a road that was closed, so this was either planned, but they didn't have time to make it, or it will be the new DLC area, or both. I mean, it was planned, they didn't have time and the resources to make it, but we can be fairly sure this will be the new area, if they ever add a DLC. At least the area where they go from. Because Endmancar Forest, as you can see, has more... If you saw the classical map with Aurai, the continent, and the other 10 locations, you will notice that there is Sierzo here, there is Endmancar Forest here, or Berg, and then you have Monsoon up there, and to the right is Abrasar Desert. And down here there was another area, but I can't really remember which one it was. So yeah, I think this will be the entry location for the new area. But I'm almost 99% sure they'll make another DLC and it will be in a few months. But so far the devs are keeping really, really quiet, and that is what worries me. I know they are working on a lot of stuff and probably... And this is the problem with modern games. They are launched on so many platforms right now. I mean, PlayStation, Xbox, PC, maybe some other ones. And then they have to work on all those ports and make them better. So, we'll just have to see what comes next. But definitely, this is an interesting thing to notice. Oh well. I guess I'm a little tired anyway. I just wanted to take this weapon. But it was such a short encounter. See you next time. Bye.